Hi guys, welcome back to Informed Beauty. It's been quite a few months, probably since February, since I've made and posted a video. I've just been very busy with work, with wedding planning. Life has been pretty crazy, but it's been busy in a good way. And I am very excited to create a video today for you about the alterations process for my wedding dress. So way back in October, I made a video about wedding dress shopping and tips that I developed for you guys for when you go wedding dress shopping to help make the process easier. And I did allude to the fact that I might make a video about wedding dress alterations. And I couldn't speak to it before because I had not gone through the alterations process. But shortly after I made that video, my wedding dress did come in October. And I tried it on again with my accessories, like my necklace, my shoes and whatnot. And then I waited quite a few months. I waited until March to start my alterations process. And now it is the end of May and my dress is finally done. Like my alterations are finally done and I'll be picking my dress up in June. My wedding is in July. So I'm just gonna go through some tips that I think would help future brides or current brides going through the wedding alterations process, wedding dress alterations process. Again, keep in mind that I'm not a seamstress. I don't work for a wedding store. I'm not necessarily an industry expert in it, but just from my own personal experience and things that I've heard from the seamstress at my wedding store, things that I've read about, just general advice for those of you that are going to be going into your alterations process to help things hopefully go a little more smoothly, a little less stressful. I think the first thing that I would say is give yourself enough time, but don't start too early. Because if your weight changes or if you're planning on losing weight, whatever it is, or if you tend to lose weight when you get stressed or you tend to gain weight when you get stressed, everybody has a different reaction. I tend to be pretty weight stable, so I wasn't as concerned about this. But generally speaking, it's good to, from what I've read, to start the alterations process 2 to 3 months before your wedding. So not too far, not too short before, not too close to the wedding. That being said, your seamstress, your wedding store, wherever you go to alter your dress, listen to whatever they suggest, but that's generally what I've heard is 2 to 3 months. I'm very happy that I started my alterations process when I did, which was beginning of March. I've had a few people tell me, oh, just wait until closer to your wedding. But because I'm so type A, I wanted to have my dress quite a ways before my wedding in July. I actually wanted to have my dress by the beginning of June, and that way I would have a month buffer in the event of something happening, something catastrophic happening with the alterations process. I just wanted that buffer room, especially because we're traveling for our wedding. It did actually take 3 months and 6 alterations appointments to get my dress to fit me like a glove. Now, that being said, it's not necessarily going to be the case for you. I've heard some people have had 2 alterations appointments, some people have had 5, some people have 3. So it really depends on your dress, your body type, your preferences. It completely depends on your specific situation. So give yourself enough time is my main, my first tip. And my second tip is be patient. So that kind of ties into, well, it took me 6 alterations appointments. And there were times where I was getting impatient and I was getting nervous. I wasn't sure if my dress was gonna turn out the way that I envisioned it. Was it really gonna fit the right way? So be patient and trust your seamstress. So whoever you choose, hopefully they're a reputable seamstress. And my wedding dress store where I got my wedding dress, they actually had a seamstress already at that store. So I utilized them. And because of the type of the dress that I had, the fabric that it was, the style of dress that it was, and my body type, it took longer to get through the alterations process and have the dress fit just right. For you, it might take less time, but don't compare yourself and the number of alterations appointments it takes you compared to someone else, because their situation could be completely different. So I had a slightly more challenging factors due to the dress type, dress style, fabric type, and all that. So they could only make one change at a time to see how that change would affect everything else in the dress. Because if you make one alteration in one portion of the dress, it has a ripple effect on other parts of the dress, the way that the dress sits in other parts of your body. And for the type of dress that I had, it was extra important to do that step by step. So you've got to be patient and trust your seamstress. Now, my third tip would be make sure you do your research and choose a good seamstress. So some people I've heard go get their wedding dress, and then once it's purchased, they'll go to a different place to get it altered. But from my understanding, a lot of wedding dress stores do offer alterations, and generally that would be something that I would suggest. I think that that's something that the wedding store would recommend because they deal with weddings all the time. They deal with wedding dresses all the time. They deal with brides all the time. So they have that experience, as opposed to maybe an alterations person that deals with regular everyday clothing. They may not have as much experience with formal wear or maybe a specific type of material like satin. That being said, there's very good alterations seamstress places out there that are not associated with a wedding store, I'm sure. So as long as you do your research, look in advance as to what the reviews are and ask questions as to what fabrics, are you familiar with working with this type of fabric? Have you worked with a wedding dress before? All those things, because you don't want to get into a situation where you commit to a seamstress, you commit to an alterations place, and they do not know what they're doing, and they make a mistake that's going to be harder to fix for someone else if you go to someone else to help fix the other seamstress's mistake. So definitely choose a reputable seamstress or a reputable alterations place, because that will help reduce the stress by quite a bit, and that will help prevent you from wasting time, precious time, when you're already busy and stressed out planning for your wedding. And that will help you trust your seamstress as well, because if they know what they're doing and it's taking longer than you expected, then you know that there's a method to their madness, so to speak. Now, my fourth tip is bring only those people with you to your alterations appointments that are going to be constructive, that don't provide you with just unsolicited advice or people that could be judgmental. You want to bring people with you that are going to calm you down in the event of stress or in the event of something not going right or you being frustrated. I brought my bridesmaids, so sometimes one of my bridesmaids would come, sometimes all three would come. It would just depend on who was available that particular day. But generally I would have at the very least one of my bridesmaids come with me to all my appointments, and that way they could learn how to bustle my dress. If there was anything specific to the dress that they needed to know about the day of the wedding, the seamstress told them. They were also there to take photos of me so that I had records of what my dress looked like at different stages of the alterations process. Because sometimes when you're standing there and you're looking at yourself, with all these pins in your dress, because they will pin you when they look at places that need to be altered. They will pin that specific part of the material. And so it can be hard to get out of your head and see what you actually look like. And when you have someone taking photos of it, then it's kind of, it gives you a different perspective. And I just wanted pictures for the memories. And I really love my dress, so I just wanted as many pictures as possible of me in it in general. But I would just advise against bringing a lot of people, especially if you're stressed about a certain part of the alterations process. You want people that are supportive, and you want probably not too many people at the same time to come with you. My other piece of advice would be bring the shoes and your underwear, so like your thongs, your panties, whatever, and if you're wearing a bra, bring the items that you plan on wearing underneath your dress or the alterations appointments, or Spanx, or whatever it is that you're gonna wear underneath the dress. Because whatever you wear under the dress will affect how this dress sits on you. A different type of bra might have a different effect on how the dress will sit on you. So you always wanna bring the exact same bra, exact same underwear, unless you decide to change it up for whatever reason, but then you'd have to alter things to sit specifically to that underwear. So that would be really important. And I know the seamstress had always was happy that I had brought a bra in that I bought specifically for the dress, and I just constantly put it on under the dress every time I came into my alterations appointment. It's good to bring your shoes in as well, because you want to make sure that the height that the shoes are at, that the dress is altered to that height if it needs to be shortened or whatnot. Now, my dress, I did not need any shortening. I'm tall. I'm not wearing heels, so I actually I'm wearing really fancy flats to my wedding. So the dress, I was lucky enough that it hits the ground at just the right spot. So I saved money on the shortening piece anyway. But definitely make sure if your dress has a tricky back or anything like that, or if your dress would have, if you would have difficulty wearing a bra with your dress, sometimes it helps to shop online. Like I actually ended up ordering a bra online that would fit the type of the style of dress that I was wearing because I knew that I definitely wanted to wear a bra under my dress for various reasons. My bust is very soft and it doesn't hold its shape very well. It's also larger. So I knew that I needed underwire, I knew that I needed straps. But I needed a specific type of style of bra that would match the type of style of dress. So it took me a little while, but I did find a really excellent bra. Now, the straps didn't quite match what the dress needed to do for the style. So what I ended up doing is I asked the alterations people at my bridal store if they were willing to alter the straps of the dress, or sorry, the straps of the bra, so that they would match the dress, the straps of the dress. And they were kind enough and so nice to be willing to do that because it's an alteration to the actual bra. It's not an alteration to the dress. And I remember being so worried that, oh my gosh, like, maybe they don't do these kinds of alterations. Maybe they have a policy in place that they can only do alterations to the dress. And as soon as I came in for my first alterations appointment, the seamstress was like, "Don't worry about it. You've got a great bra. It's just a minor alteration. It's nothing crazy. We can definitely do it." And I guess that leads into my next tip is be sure to voice your concerns or opinions. So if you don't like something, if they tell you, "Oh, we can sew cups in," or "You don't need to wear a bra," like if they don't quite understand the shape of your body or how you have experience with how things sit on your bust, for example, or things like that, voice your opinion and let them know, "Hey, like is there any way that I could wear a bra and you can adjust it to to match the dress, or what are other options besides just sewing in cups?" For example, my wedding dress store also sewed in, they can sew in an entire bra under the dress. That sometimes that's something that they do. So online is a good resource for ordering specialty bras, not necessarily bras that you would be able to find on in store. And just voicing your concerns or any questions that you have to the actual alterations person really helps. And that really helped me put some of my anxieties at ease because I really wanted to make sure that my bust was staying in place and it was at the right spot on my torso that I wanted it to be. But those are just some things to keep in mind. And you don't want to be bringing in different underwear for every alterations appointment because then your dress will be sitting slightly different every time. Now, the next piece of advice, it would be a good opportunity during your alterations appointments to try out veils. So if you haven't decided on a veil yet, or even some accessories, it could be a good time during the first few couple alterations appointments to bring in the jewelry you think you might be wearing to the wedding, to your wedding, or test out some veils. I purchased a veil on Amazon because I didn't want to spend a ton of money on like a $150 veil from the bridal store. So I brought my veil in, I tested it out with my dress during, I think, probably my third alterations appointment. I loved it. It worked really great with the dress. So then I know I'm going to be using that veil. When my dress came in October, I actually just had an appointment just to go and try on the dress because my bridal store lets us do that. And I brought all my jewelry, all my accessories to try on with the dress. And that was the one time I did that because I didn't want to bring them every time, all my necklace and my earrings and whatnot. But I just wanted to see the whole package together because I ordered all these things separately, the dress, the necklace, the earrings. I wanted to see what it all looks like together. Luckily, I was happy with how it looked, so I put those jewelry pieces to rest until the wedding day, and I know that they look good with the dress. But that the alterations appointments could be a good opportunity to trial out those accessories. Those are all of my suggestions and tips for the alterations process. Like I said, the alterations process is going to be unique to each of you. There's no one right number of alterations appointments that it's going to take. It will all depend on your dress, your situation. I believe my alterations cost ended up being about $350 altogether, just because there were different areas, different parts of the dress that they had to alter. I did save some money, like I mentioned, on the length because I'm tall. I ended up not having to adjust the length of it, which was nice. But my alterations appointment costs ended up being under, I'm definitely sure it was under 400, but most definitely under $500. It was about 350 if I remember correctly. And I still have about a month to go until the wedding, just over a month. So what the bridal store does once you're done alterations, and I was done with alterations this past Saturday, so it was just a couple days ago. I tried it on, things were great. They said that they were gonna press the dress, like iron it, hang it up nicely inside of the garment bag. And luckily their garment bag is not see-through, so that my fiance will not see it while we're traveling or when I bring it into the house. So I made an appointment for the beginning of June to come and pick up my dress once it's nicely pressed and hung up and everything. And then I just plan on storing it in my closet until the wedding day. But I do remember the seamstress saying that she prefers brides to pick up the dress later, even because they can hold on to it at the bridal store. And that's just because she finds that fabric can take on smells from the house. So if you're cooking, especially if it's a small area like an apartment, if you're cooking, sometimes a dress can take up scents from the house. You don't want your scent of, you don't want your wedding dress to be smelling like broccoli on your wedding day or anything like that. But I, since I'm traveling for the wedding, I told her I booked an appointment for beginning of June, but I might come in and change it and maybe pick it up mid-June. But I definitely don't want to wait until end of June because things are going to get crazy as we prep for our wedding trip and so on and so forth. But I'm happy I gave myself a little bit of that wiggle or buffer room. My best advice would be to ask directly the bridal store that you're working with or the seamstress that you're working with how long they anticipate that you would require or how far in advance they require you to begin alterations. And for some of you, it literally might be just a really quick fix, or like a very easy one or two appointment situation. But I am so excited to finally have my dress very soon in my house, and I cannot wait for my fiance to see my wedding dress and surprise him because he has no idea what it looks like, and that was my goal. Yeah, I'm just incredibly excited. And I will be making another video after the wedding is already done about traveling with your wedding dress because there were definitely some concerns and anxieties I had about traveling with my wedding dress. Once I go through the process and once I finalize some of my research, then I can do a video on that. And hopefully that will help some of you brides that are traveling for your wedding. It's becoming more common to do destination weddings. So that is definitely, I think, a video that would be very relevant to I think many of you. If you have questions or if you just wanted to comment about your own alterations experience, let me know down below how many alterations appointments you had, if you had any stressors or anxieties about it, or how did you have an overall positive experience with your alterations appointments? Where did you go get your dress altered? Was it at the bridal store you shopped at? Was it somewhere else? Let me know all of that down below. And I really hope that my tips and advice have helped you, but ultimately always listen to what your bridal store says because it can vary from place to place in the world or place to place in the country, things like that. But that is it for me today. I look forward to creating more wedding content as well as beauty content. And as always, have a wonderful day. I will talk to you guys soon. Bye.